Magbayanihan na. Magbayanihan na.
Important things on how we can manage stress and anxiety, especially during this time that we have the pandemics. Okay, so pandemics can be stressful. We know that for a fact. The coronavirus disease 2019 or the COVID-19 pandemic may be stressful for people. So fear and anxiety about a new disease and what could happen can be overwhelming and cause strong emotions, especially in adults and children. So public health actions like yung ating social distancing, it can make people feel isolated and lonely, and it could increase stress and anxiety as well. However, these actions are necessary to reduce the spread of COVID-19. Coping with stress in a healthy way will make you, the people you care about, and your community stronger. Now, stress during an infectious disease outbreak can sometimes cause the following: fear and worry about your own health, and of course the health of your loved ones, your financial situation or the job, or loss of support services you rely on. Another could be changes in sleeping or eating patterns, and also difficulty sleeping or concentrating. Another is that of worsening of chronic health problems, and the worst is in the mental health conditions. Okay. So you need to take care of your mental health. You may experience increased stress during this pandemic, so fear and anxiety can be overwhelming and it causes strong emotions. So everyone reacts differently to stressful situations, and how you respond to the COVID-19 pandemic can depend on your background, your social support from family or friends, your financial situation, and your health and emotional background, the community also which you live in, and there are other factors. So the changes that can happen because of the COVID-19 pandemic, the ways we try to contain the spread of the virus, can affect anyone. Okay, so there are different people who may respond more strongly to stress of a crisis, and they include people who are at higher risk for severe illness from COVID-19. For example, the older people and also people with underlying health conditions. Who else? The children and teens. And then people caring for family members or loved ones. And of course, the frontline workers such as the healthcare providers, the first responders, retail clerks, and others as well. So essential workers who work in the food industry because they are allowed to work. We need to be supported with the food. So people who have existing mental health conditions, okay, they respond more strongly to this stress. Who else? People who have lost their jobs, had their work hours reduced, or had other major changes to their employment. And then people who have disabilities or development delay. People who are socially isolated from others, including people who live alone, and people in rural or frontier areas. Then people who do not have access to information in their primary language, especially the OFW, they are not, these overseas workers were not, they are not having access to information because they are foreigners. And then people who are experiencing homelessness. Okay? So that's why we need to take care of ourselves and also our community. taking care of your friends and your family can be a stress reliever, but it should be balanced with
helping
care
others
you.
Cope with their stress, such as providing social support, can also make our community stronger.
So during times of increased social distancing, people can still maintain social connections and also care for their mental health. So we do have virtual communications like phones or video chats. This can help you and your loved ones feel less lonely and isolated. So let me give you also some healthy ways to cope with stress. The first one is, of course, you need to know what to do if you are sick. And of course, we are very much concerned about COVID-19. So you need to contact a health professional before you start any self-treatment for COVID-19. The second way is we need to know where and how to get treatment and other support services and resources, including counseling or therapy. Okay, so we may have in person or probably through telehealth services, okay, the virtual or the online support system. Another way is we can take care of our emotional health. Taking care of your emotional health will help you think clearly and react to the urgent needs to protect yourself and your family. Another way is, of course, we can take breaks from watching, reading, or listening to news stories, because sometimes the news, what we are hearing in the news, we may feel some negativism about it. So hearing about the pandemic repeatedly can be upsetting. Okay, so that's why we may take some break from watching or listening to those negative energies, you would say. Okay, then we need to also take care of our body. Take deep breaths, stretch. Okay, we need to do some stretching, or of course meditate. Okay, you need to try to eat healthy, well-balanced meals. Of course, exercising regularly, and get plenty of sleep. Okay, and of course we must avoid excessive alcohol use. Okay, another way is we need to make time to unwind. Okay, try to do some activities that you enjoy, like for example having bonding with your family members, or you may make use of movie watching. Okay, so that could be some way to have some family support. And then you need to connect with others. Talk with people you trust about your concerns and how you are feeling. Okay, and then connect with your community or faith-based organization. Nowadays, of course, we need to follow the government rules on social distancing. So measures are in place. But we can consider connecting online through social media or by phone or by mail. And also, since religious gathering are not allowed yet, so we can have the virtual meeting through Zoom meeting. Connect with your brothers, sisters, with your religious organization. Okay, we can do that. And of course, through meditation of the Word of God, we can get strength out of that. And of course, we need to take time to pray. Pray for those people who are affected by the pandemics. Okay, that's one way to give some support. Okay, so we need to connect with our community and also our faith-based organizations. Okay, so we need to know the facts to help reduce stress. Knowing the facts about COVID-19 and stopping the spread of rumors can help reduce stress and
anxiety and also the stigma. So understanding the risk to yourself and people you care about can help you connect with others and make an outbreak less stressful. So I think I've given enough tips. Okay, this is also what I'm doing. Okay, so you may also add some tips on how to manage stress and anxiety, especially during this time of pandemics. Okay, so that would be all, and thank you very much for the opportunity of giving me this moment to share with you some tips.
Bayanihan, pagtutulungan, walang kupas na kaugalian. Tagatibay, sinasabuhay, galak sa puso ay walang kapantay. Panahon